Let's look at the elections-related stories and political parties in the country risk rejection of their party's nomination by the Electoral Commission if they fail to submit their audited accounts by May 31. Director of Finance at the Commission, Joseph Kwikwesamwa, disclosed that only one out of the 25 registered political parties have submitted their 2015 audited account to the Commission.
In pursuant to the Political Parties Law Act 574, the Commission has directed the 25 registered political parties to submit their audited accounts by May 31, 2016. In 2012, out of 25 political parties, only the Convention People's Party, CPP, National Democratic Party, NDP, the Democratic People's Party, DPP, and the Great Consolidated Popular Party, GCPP, submitted their audited accounts to the Commission. In 2013, the National Democratic Party, NDP, Democratic People's Party, DPP, and the Great Consolidated Popular Party, GCPP, submitted their accounts to the party. The National Democratic Party, NDP, Democratic People's Party, DPP, and the Great Consolidated Popular Party, GCPP, submitted their accounts in 2014. In 2015, only the Progressive People's Party, PPP, submitted their accounts to the Commission. Director of Finance at the Commission, Joseph Kweku Asamoah, said the Commission is prepared to reject nomination of the 14 political parties. NDC General Secretary Johnson Esidu Nketia was hopeful the party will meet the deadline.
Because we have had challenges with our auditor, we are changing the accounts office team and so on. So those are the only places we have challenges that we are working hard to address. But in terms of all the other things, we don't have any problem.
Acting Chairman of NPP, Freddie Blay, welcomed the decision by the Electoral Commission.
It's better than now than not at all.
PNC Chairman Bernard Mona says the party is working assiduously to ensure it meets the requirements of the law.
It's something that all of us should work hard to ensure that we are able to comply with. And I have instructed the General Secretary and the National Treasurer to ensure that they meet with our auditors so that they will be able to provide the needed audited accounts to the Electoral Commission.
The law states that political parties must have offices in 2/3 of all the districts. But in 2013, according to the Commission, only the NDC and MPP were able to meet the requirement.